evil terrorist terror terrifies terrified livestock as they beg psychopathic fascist murdering rulers to strip them of liberty, face fuck them with a giant cock of lies, and slaughter women and children in the name of freedom. But it's not the end of the world. Deadly radioactive atomic fires rage on planet Earth as Fukushima triple meltdown irradiates the planet and spews 600 tons of nuclear waste into the ocean day after day after day. But it's not the end of the world. Burn, baby, burn! Famine, war, drought, disease, plague, pestilence. Did I say famine already? Coming your way as runaway climate change boils you like a frog in your own piss and shit. Threatening megatastic mass extinction of all life. But it's not the end of the world. Okay, well, that one might be. It's the greatest show on the planet. It's the most awesome, spectacular, amazing, splendid entertainment you will ever see, because this is your life on planet Earth. Hello, Temple Consciousness. The planet's fucked, it's your fault, and it's getting worse. Welcome to the fucking show. I'm Deek Jackson, and I'm already dead. In tonight's show, I'll be saving the world from planet-raping psychos and explaining why counterculture is full of retarded losers wasting your time with pointless pish as they metaphorically wank their flaccid revolutionary members to orgasm until ugly mutant infertile jism dribbles out, briefly staining the carpet till it congeals to a useless lump you have to scrape off your shoe and throw in the garbage. But first, the headlines tonight. Hey, bonsoir, je suis Charlie. Freedom of speech versus extremist terror. Following the 7-1 terror attack in Paris, the free world is united in expressing its unity and opposing terror. Je suis Charlie. This means you are free. Free to say what you want, even if others find it offensive. Je suis Charlie means we are the civilized moral superiors and we know what's right and wrong. So, from this day on, our industrialized West will never bomb another country into submission, never install another puppet regime, never support another fascist government with arms, trade, or tacit approval. We will, of course, boycott China, Israel, Saudi Arabia, Egypt, Burma, Russia, etc. Ha ha, that'll never fucking happen. No, honestly. We will close all arms factories, recall our fleets of warships, scrap our drones, dismantle our global surveillance systems, and apologize for bombing and invading all those countries we bombed and invaded. It's a great story. Except it's total bollocks. You are not free to say what you want, and we in the West are not the good guys. Not in France, not in Britain, and definitely not in America. In fact, in all of these countries, if you say certain things, you will be arrested and locked up for a very long time. For example, let's riot until we collapse the economy and bringing down the governments that kill innocent women and children. Come on, let's do it. Who's with me? Haha, only kidding. Or death to the royalty! Let's rise up against all of our land-owning tyrants, string them up from lampposts, and take back the land that is our birthright! Ha ha ha! I'm only kidding! Or let's all make bombs, really big bombs, and drop them from a great height onto people doing things we don't like, or people we just want to get rid of. Come on, it's not murder, it's national security! Yeah, let's national security those niggers to death! Then we'll national security some fucking hippies to death. I fucking hate hippies. It's freedom. Freedom to say what you think. Hooray! Je suis Charlie. I have a dream. I have a dream that one day all of us economic niggas will be free. Free to say, let's kill white folks. For the white folks is evil. All white folks is evil. And we should totally national security them into little pieces in a bloody revolution across the world, in the name of freedom and national security, of course.
Please do not try this at home. Deek has an artistic license and many years of experience in saying what the fuck he wants. Saying what you want in your country may be subject to status, hazardous to your health, and lead to your slow, painful death. In other news, three nuclear meltdowns are still underway at Fukushima in Japan. The world's leading experts in nuclear meltdowns have not gathered at Fukushima because they don't exist. There are, in fact, no experts in this enormous fuck-up. Instead, the management of this planetary catastrophe is in the hands of, the people who caused this planetary catastrophe. Don't worry, they will keep you totally uninformed of their progress. A recent risk assessment of Earth's nuclear facilities revealed that only about 1 billion people will die when they all fuck up and spew plutonium into the atmosphere, leaving 6 billion people to clean up and blame some Muslims they showed us on TV. In a related story, climate change is underway on Earth. I really don't care if you believe that or think humans caused it, it's a fact. The future's not as good as it used to be and may not exist at all. The rest of this item is just me shouting, methane hydrate. Methane hydrate! Methane hydrate! Methane hydrate! Ah! Methane hydrate! Methane hydrate! Methane hydrate! Thanks, and now the weather. Fake false flag terror attacks in France will lead to loss of liberty, fascist state Islamophobic nigger bombing, and conditioning to accept forever war, empire building, genocide, and ugly patriotic jingoist music on your radio. Triple meltdown in Fukushima irradiation of planet Earth will continue forever and ever and ever. I'm not joking, this can never be fixed. They can't even clean up the shit we made that isn't on fire. Honestly, we've really fucked up and there's no going back. Climate change, whether you think humans cause it or not, is going to kill you and most other life on Earth. Only joking, it's going to kill everything, right down to the bacteria in your snot. Ha 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 ha! I don't mind if you disagree with me. I mind if you're dumb as a fucking post and your abject stupidity might lead me to waste a microsecond of my life engaging with you. And the outlook for the future? Exponential decline of the Earth's ecosystem, economic collapse, mass die-off, war, tyranny, fascism, and desperate geoengineering madness. Have a nice weekend! Is it just me? Or is everything really fucked up? And nobody's doing anything about it? The powers that be run this planet like a Nazi concentration camp. The whole place is owned by a few wealthy banking families. Their henchmen and partners in crime will kill you and dance on your grave if you threaten their hegemony. Consumerism is raping the planet to death on a minute-by-minute basis in your face. We littered our biosphere with nuclear waste, the management of which is in the hands of the deluded retards who made it. The industrialization of slavery, wealth creation for the few, have doomed us all to a future of environmental catastrophe. And to combat this overarching tyranny and free us from slavery, our best hope is Occupy Wall Street and the Ice Bucket Challenge. Really? If you think the gurus of counterculture, pishing on about truth, waking people up, and higher consciousness, can, will, might, ever, may, change this, you're just as fucked up as they are. But wait! Unlike many other pointless, vapid, ranting, egomaniac, attention-seeking, fear-mongering, book-selling, download my ebook, DVD, PDF, dick-for-brain charlatans, I'm going to do something about it. Something practical and useful and I'm going to give you good advice and information for free right now so you too can help rid the planet of psychopaths and or limit the damage they are doing. Okay, let's get started. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, come with me on a great adventure as we bend our wills, pool our resources and collectify our energy to buy planet Earth. Let's just pause for a moment while you absorb the enormity and significance of that proposition. Buy the planet? But that's absurd, Deek. Won't it cost a lot of money? Owning things is just part of the problem anyway, and we could never do that. What about all the different countries? Fact is, you're nuts, and anyway, I don't trust you. Deek will probably just run away with the money, buy a Rolls Royce, a big house, and snort coke while he bangs hookers in the back of a limo. Sounds like fun. Okay, well, fuck you. I'll buy the planet myself. It might take me a while, but while you losers are bitching about the Illuminati and our fascist overlords, I'll be saving my money. In fact, from this day on, every time I make a video, I'm putting a pound in my piggy bank. Every time you hear me reminding you of how pointless protest and activism are in the grand scheme of things, I'll be a little bit closer to saving the planet from consumerism, industry, chemical agro, big pharma, the boogeyman, things that go bump in the night, and satanic New World Order shape-shifting alien goo from planet you're a fucking moron. Furthermore, I challenge you to take the ice bucket challenge was a total crock of pish that lined the pockets of an unaccountable pharmaceutical charity that stashed all the money raised in an account to be used at a later date for stuff that we don't have to tell you about. Sorry. What I meant to say was, I challenge you to buy the planet as well. I challenge you to make a video pledging a dollar of your local currency, whatever it is, for the planet. A video where you place one unit of your fake fiat currency in your piggy bank, symbolizing you taking responsibility for the planet and not complaining about some other cunt fucking it up who you'd like to change. Don't spend your money, save your money. Join with others, pool your resources, sell shit you don't need. Go busking, rip the heart out of the cancerous economy created by a few wealthy bankers by not spending their money on anything but land. And if you want to help me buy the planet, PayPal donations to ordonomundi@gmail.com. If you think I might blow it on coke and hookers, keep it and buy the planet yourself. Remember, land is what you need to live on. If you don't have land, you're just livestock on someone else's. Land is freedom, land is power, and land is the only thing worth buying. So, join with me and let's buy the planet. Hey, what can go wrong? Okay, now the next bit. You may be lucky enough to have some kind of asset. Your family home, large sums of cash, a fancy car, the mineral rights to chili, or maybe a video of Bill Clinton and Prince Andrew spit-roasting that chick on a massage table back in the 90s. Whatever. But did you know your life is an asset? And currently, your life is an asset of the planet-raping machine called the economy. You are accounted for in the Great Ledger as an economic unit at their disposal. Literally. So, here's what to do with your assets. Incorporate them. Incorporate them just like the few wealthy families who own everything of value do. Place all your worldly goods into a financial instrument called a corporation. Here they will be safe from harm, free from liability, and protected from exploitation. Incorporate your family home, your money, your life. As an individual, you are weak and defenseless against lying, thieving scum who own everything. As a corporation, you're equal to them, at least on paper. Okay, I may or may not be back to reiterate this great advice again and again and again. So, let's sum up. Save your money and buy the planet. Or give it to me and I'll buy the planet. No, honestly, I will. Incorporate your assets, including your life, as soon as possible. In the UK, this costs as little as £50. Fight fire with fire. I'll say that again. Fight fire with fire. I don't like the idea Earth can be owned by anybody, but since it can, let it be us. You and me. Hey, we're the good guys, right?
Thank you.
we got lots of dumb and it's free. So saddle up, sing along, whoa, people got to know. Freedom needs us all to be stars in the show. Now I know it seems a little odd and it seems a little strange how liberty has disappeared in freedom's name. Freedom. Yeah, we got our freedom that you need. Oh, freedom. After all.